So after today's activities, I've prepared a few questions for you guys.
And I made a few of my own.
Number one question. How have you grown up today?
No, how has this activity affected your role in society and humanity as a whole? Anyone?
Well, in response to Dallas's question, which I might add I think was very wisely put,
thank you.
I feel that I've grown both as a member of Farmington High School and a human being.
Thanks, Rob. Thanks for your insight, but that was my question, and I appreciate
Excuse
it.
Excuse me, that was my question.
Whatever. How can you impact society now, using what you've learned? For some bonus points.
Well, I, for one, feel I can identify with the Asian sweatshop workers who make our sneakers.
Brilliant. Got an answer, John. And what have you learned today?
No, I think a better question would be, how can you make connections with this and other liberating texts we've read in the past, and how has it affected the American dream?
And how can you use it every day?
American dream.
What was the question again? Whatever. But I've learned that there's a world of difference between an 8 and an 8 wide. I mean, at first I didn't want to wear an 8 wide because it would be, like, socially retarded. But it just, like, gives me so much more room, and there's just so much more give, and, like, I don't even know how to explain it. Like, you don't even know.
Brilliant. That was brilliant. Thanks for answering my question. And so, Monica, how can you use what you've learned on a day-to-day basis?
I think a better question would be, how can you relate this to the American dream?
That's not
yes,
the right
that
question.
Is a better question than
Who
yours.
Who cares about the American
your
dream?
Question
not.
Hey guys, why don't you both ask your best question? One each.
Alright, I can do this. Why don't you go first, Arnie?
Hold on a second. Do you need a pen to write it down?
I think I'll just take this one, thank you.
You done there?
Of course I am.
Okay. Ladies first. I guess I can go first, because some people are a bit immature. Have you learned anything today? If so, how can you use it to benefit society? And if one of these methods were to be social integration, how would you go about beginning the social movement? And if so, would you use any of the lessons you've learned today, if you have learned any? And if so to all of the above, would you be willing to share your answers for some? How do you say, bonus points?
I felt bad for him, so thought I'd give him a little bit of support.
Rick.
Yes, thank you, Arnie. That was brilliant clip. I appreciate it. Let's see. First of all, what have I learned? I have learned an immense amount of knowledge today, and I really think that your preemptive strike of the social integration, I think that was perfect, because that's exactly what I would use in the situation.
Yeah, thanks.
Poor choice of terms for a poor little question. I think I'll move on to my question now.
Yeah, I want to do that.
Alright, how about this one? In light of the events that transpired over the last 7 hours, 37 minutes, and 28 seconds, how do you feel you have grown, evolved, as in a CPU system whose RAM has been upgraded and coarsened and overclocked by 300 megahertz.
Well, if anybody knew what a RAM was, they still wouldn't answer your question.
Obviously, you two ill-educated
Sorry.
Understand what it is.
Dallas, that was genius, quite frankly.
Thank you.
I mean, it was pure brilliance. And
naturally.
Yeah, I know I can't match it. I know I can't even come close, but I will, and,
yeah, I've never been much of a spur-of-the-moment BSer. It works better on paper.
There was one thing, one tidbit of wisdom that might come to your own that I picked up over the course of the day. And it really hit me when I walked into the classroom this afternoon. And I looked down at my shoes, and a ray of light I just squinted in from the outside.
Amazing.
And I looked down at my shoe, and at first I thought it was a ray of white light. But then, with new wide-open eyes, I realized that white light is, in fact, all the colors of the rainbow.
Exactly. The full spectrum. That was perfect.
Thanks, Dawson.
Well, after that narrative, I think we all can agree that my efforts for today have been a success. I see you've all learned what it truly means to walk in someone else's shoes.
I mean, Mark, please.
What?
Still wearing the oak there?
Shut up.
You know, it's days like this when I realize why I do what I do. I teach kids. But not just about what a triangle is or about how many people died in the Civil War. I teach kids about life. And you know, I think I've learned something myself. Walking in someone else's shoes sure feels kind of nice. I think I'll try it out for a few more days.